getting it on, and they ain't leaving till 6 in the morning. So what you wanna do? Shit, I got a pocket full of rubbers and my homeboys do too. So turn off the lights and close the door.
But what?
We don't love them hoes.
Yeah. So we gon' smoke an ounce to this. G's up, hoes down, why you motherfuckers bounce to this?
Rolling down the street, smoking in clouds, sipping on gin and juice.
Laid back.
With my mind on my money and my money on my mind.
Rolling down the street, smoking in clouds, sipping on gin and juice.
Laid back.
With my mind on my money and my money on my mind.
I got me some sequins gin. Everybody got their cups, but they ain't chipped in. Now this type of shit happens all the time. You gotta get yours, but fool, I gotta get mine. Everything is fine when you're listening to the D.O.G. I got the cultivating music that be captivating me. Who listens to the words that I speak as I take me a drink to the middle of the street and get to mackin' to this bitch named Shady. She used to be the homeboy's lady.
Oh, that bitch.
Degrees when I tell that bitch, please raise up off these NUTs. Did you get none of these at ease? As I mob with the dog pound, feel the breeze. B.I. Chuck J.
Rolling down the street, smoking in clouds, sipping on gin and juice.
Laid back.
With my mind on my money and my money on my mind.
Rolling down the street, smoking in clouds, sipping on gin and juice.
Laid back. Later on that day, my homie Dr. Dre came through with a gang to Tango Ray and a fat ass Jay of some bubonic chronic that made me choke. Shit, this ain't no joke. I had to back up off the bitch and sit my fuck down.
Welcome back to the show. Welcome back to the show, man. The number to the show is 404-822-5467. You can also email me at Doug@thedougstewartshow.com. I'd love to hear from some of the ladies to the show that boycotted yesterday. The number is 404-822-5467. Just to hear from you, just to hear your voices, your beautiful voices. Can't start to tell you how bad yesterday was. Oh, man, look, we have a caller right now. Thank you for calling the Doug Stewart Show. What's your name, where are you calling from, and what would you like to talk about?
Hey, Doug, Sporting Heels.
This is who?
Sporting Heels.
Tiffany Sports and Heels. Good morning, Tiffany Sports and Heels. Welcome back to the show.
Thanks, I think. Can you hear me okay?
I'm sorry?
Can you hear me okay?
Yeah, I can hear you fine.
Okay. So, first, I think that you owe us an apology first.
Oh, no, no, Tiffany. I said it at the very beginning of the show. I don't know if you heard it, but yesterday was a horrible ordeal for us all the men. And I said it at the very top of the show, said it several times yesterday, as a matter of fact. Whatever happened a couple of days ago, which I still don't fully understand, we apologize. We apologize. Yesterday was a miserable show without you ladies. It was.
Okay, so I want to clarify, since you said you don't understand what happened,
okay.
I want to clarify what happened.
Okay.
So that you understand where you made a mistake. I know you men have a hard time retaining information when y'all mess up, and y'all sure don't want to hear it from us. So let me just remind you where all this came from.
Okay, great.
It's
I need those who've
been asking on Facebook and
right.
wherever.
Okay.
Okay, so I'm going to start from the latest, and then I'm going to work my way to the oldest.
Wait a minute. Is that many
so the
things?
Latest, yeah, is that many. So the latest is, so yesterday, you and the fellas decided to have a, what I can describe as a boys, let's be raunchy because the girls ain't here. Bachelor party.
No, no. Wait a minute. Whoa, wait a minute.
Just like any other party, just like any other party the all boys have, y'all can't keep no secrets.
Whoa, wait a minute, wait a minute.
There's always a few men who are down for the cause of the ladies.
Well, first of all, that's
for
not.
For whatever reason.
First of all, none of that's true, but I'm just asking, who came and told the ladies anything about what happened on the show yesterday?
That person who's been issued those coupons will not be revealed.
What? Okay, go ahead. I disagree with that, but go ahead.
Okay, so there was a lot going on with Abby's. There was a lot of cheering and grunting and hooting and hollering and being led by the fearless leader yourself.
No, no, wait a minute, wait a minute, wait a minute, wait a minute, wait a minute. I want to say and state for the record, none of what you just said is true. You have been thoroughly misinformed. I'd like to know who was the person that came and told you this, though, just for my...
I've already told you the person who holds that coupon book will not be revealed. I might need it for the future.
Okay, all right. Well, I disagree. For the record, I disagree, but go ahead. What's the next thing?
Okay, then, previously to that, the way you guys acted when three ladies came in the top five for DraftKings is ridiculous. Some people accusing other people of writing algorithms, sluggo.
Right.
I don't even play DraftKings, but I got somehow dragged as I created some kind of mysterious whatever.
You are a sinister.
But the fact that you guys we listen to talk radio, and sports talk radio specifically, and your show. We could choose any other sports talk radio show before.
Right.
But the ladies choose yours.
Right.
We're very active.
Right.
On, you know, and the fact that you think we have to have our husband's help or they have to have their husband's or boyfriend's help in order to win DraftKings one time in 3 years.
Right.
And the way you guys acted all, booty all sore because we, I don't even understand.
Right. Let me say this.
Again, led by our fearless leader, the host.
No. Wait a minute. You got it all wrong. Now, I will acknowledge that, yes, there were a lot of caveman-ish type attitudes when it was revealed that three of the top five winners, okay, in the DraftKings League this past weekend were ladies. I ask that you excuse those cavemen, okay? That wasn't me. I just said to myself that was very interesting. That's all I said about it.
Why is it interesting? We participate in a sports talk show. It'd be different if we were on a fashion, that's all we talk about is fashion, or we talk about whatever, it doesn't matter. We're listening to a sports talk show, obviously we know something about sports, or else we wouldn't be here.
Right. I agree 100%. And you know what? That's why I apologize, and that's why we're happy to have you back, and that's why yesterday's show, even though it got deleted from the interweb.
It didn't get deleted before I downloaded it, and I'm sharing it with all the ladies.
No, wait a minute.
Already done.
Wait.
Already done.
The show.
And I'm getting transcripts.
The show.
And I'm getting transcripts of the downloaded audio.
No, listen.
So that there's no mistaking.
The show that you have was performed by some dude named Gal Trowitz. No, Gal Trowitz. He's a fake, sinister pirate man.
Doug Stewart.
No, it wasn't me.
Same voice.
No! Wait a minute. Wait. Let me talk. Let me say something. That was not me. I think that that is still floating out there, but I just want to reassure you and the ladies that anything that you heard yesterday as far as the show, it was not by me. It was by Gal Trowitz, and he's an evil, evil, sinister person. Okay?
No, not okay. It was Doug Stewart. And it would make it easier if you just said, you know what? Like you said on the show yesterday.
Mm-hmm.
The ladies don't want to be here. They want to boycott. Then it's a boys' trip. Remember that?
No, that wasn't me. No! No. Now, we got to let you go. And you know what? In honor of you being the first lady to call the show back after this legendary boycott on yesterday, I am not going to shoot your ass off. Let me just say that right now. I'm not going to shoot you off.
I have a recommendation. I have a recommendation to fix all this stuff. A really good one, too.
Okay.
All the fellas, since you can't win at DraftKings, take that money, pull it together, go to DougieDeals.com, get that flowers link, and send it to the Stewettes.
Okay, that's a great idea. Now, we didn't even get a chance to go to the story on Trump and these UCLA players. We'll get to that at the top of the hour, okay? And you're listening to the Doug Stewart Show. Let me first of all say, that was a lot to digest, okay? Let me first say to Tiffany, thank you for calling the show. And yes, I understand that there's of a multitude of shows that y'all can listen to, you know? They all are pretty whack in comparison to my show, but that's neither here nor there. I understand that. Now you choose your time, your listening time to listen to us here at the Two Live Shoes Radio Network and the Doug Stewart Show. So first of all, thank you. I understand that. Okay? I understand that. I disagree with you on some of your takes about what's transpired over the last couple of days, but that's fine. We're moving on. I mean, we're not going to look back. We're going to move forward. As you can tell, I'm the kinder, gentler Doug Stewart. I didn't shoot your ass off the air just now. So it's all good. We're going to move on. I'd like to, Tiffany, do me a favor. Email me, though. I would very much like to find out who is this person that told y'all that we had some type of on-air party, guide trip, just, I don't know, just crazy, rambunctious things going on yesterday, and that the show was phenomenal without the women. I'd like to know. I'd like to know. Now, no harm is going to come to this person. I just like to talk to that person and find out where their head is coming from. Like, you know, why do they feel the way that they do? Okay? So, yeah, let me know. Let me know who that is. But thank you, Tiffany, for calling the show. Mayor Mo Cheese, the Laker fan. Doug, Charles June B. Anthony, snitchless. Charles June B. Anthony. Okay, so this is supposedly the person that told the ladies that we were having a good time or something like that. Okay, I'm not familiar. I think I have seen the name in the chat room before. But give me a little bit more intel on why you feel like Mo Cheese Laker fan that Charles B. Anthony is the snitch. I mean the person that went to... Charles, I'm writing down the name right now. And I'll do a little bit of research, more research. There was a lot of back and forth in the Two Live Stews radio chat group yesterday. And so I didn't have time to really go through it thoroughly. So you're saying if I go into the chat room that I'll see evidence that Charles June B. Anthony is the culprit for telling ladies, first of all, lies about this supposed fun that we had on the Doug Stewart show yesterday. So you're saying this person, Charles B. or June B. Anthony, is the person that supplied the information to the ladies. I will do some research on that. Yeah, buddy. All right, so when we get back from the break, still love to hear phone calls from ladies today. Thorny Switch, if you're out there, you know, it's been said many times that the number one hellraiser from the ladies that really organized the ladies is the one that you just heard on the phone just now. Tiffany Sports and Heels, along with her partner, the great Thorny Switch. So if Thorny's out there right now, I'd love to hear from Thorny, you know. I'd love to hear from Thorny, all right? Don't go away. Back in 3 minutes, top of the hour, the Doug Stewart Show.
Interesting, it's me, Dana Dane. I live in a house with my two stepdad and two stepbrothers who treated me bad. I cook, I clean, I scrub the floors, and I was like an errand boy running to the store. My brothers, they used to boast and brag. We've got fresh gear and you got rags. Even worse than that, to make me feel low, they gave me a straw hat while they had kangaroos. Girls used to say, Dane, you're so cute, but you get no rap with them polyester suits. Well, one day up the avenue, there was a man surrounded by the four green crew. He said,
hear ye, come one, come all. The princess is having a royal ball. If you can rap, also dress fresh, you might win a date with the sweet princess.
Well, I ran home when I heard the news flash. I bust through the door straight to my stepdad. I said, stepdad, may I? And before I could finish,
hell no,
he replied. My brothers began when they were getting